waterline improvements. Now we're getting into our 3D users here. So Waterline Toolpath. This is Mastercam's probably basic, most basic high-speed toolpath we have. And that's why we like it so much. It creates flat geometry, doing XY passes in Z step downs incrementally. So exact Z step downs working its way down. The simple nature of this makes it one of our favorite toolpaths. What are the strengths of this toolpath? It does simple, predictable tool motion. We know what it's going to do. It's going to take our model, it's going to slice it in exact step downs, and it's going to do 2D passes. It allows us for some arc motion, so it even allows us to use it in older controls because it has smaller NC file size. Now it does come with some weaknesses. Because it's so simple, our constant Z step downs can leave an excessive amount of stock in areas that fall between our step downs. So if you have a 2mm step down, it may miss that flat. So it often requires a second toolpath to come in and clean it up. So if we take a look here, here's an example of a traditional waterline main weakness. Toolpath is giving us exactly what we asked for. I said every vertical step down of 2mm, take a cut. Well, unfortunately, these vertical step downs almost never match our real world parts. Now that flat isn't going to be exactly 10mm down from the top. So it's going to come in and it's going to miss. And in this case, it leaves a little more than a millimeter on the flat surface there. So that's a ton of material missing. So let's take a look at how Mastercam solved this problem for this year and really made Waterline a super versatile toolpath. We come in, take a look at our example part here in the corner. And just so you guys know, I did crop the regen times out of this video, so you're going to see some really fast regeneration, so we're not sitting here wasting time. On our cut parameters page, we added this new critical depths feature. We get a drop down with a whole bunch of options. I'm going to hit some of the major ones here. We're just going to launch the first include flats. You'll notice our toolpath motion now stayed with our 2mm step down, but added a pass at every flat. So pretty cool. It got them, but it's a little inefficient. I don't really need a whole pass there. So I'm going to turn on my include contact and give it a little extension here. You know, 5mm extension, generate my toolpath. Now we get a simple contour at each flat with a little bit of extension lead, my 5mm, finishing up our part. This is super handy. So what if I go into flats only? If I've got all vertical walls and enough flute on my end mill, this flats only works as basically a traditional finishing pass, like doing a contour, but in 3D. It takes a pass at every flat that it sees, works its way around. So if you've got enough flute, this could really finish your part up pretty easy. Then we come down into contact flats only. I'm looking at this as a secondary finishing. I can come in after the end, roughing down with a different tool, finish all of my parts like its own automatic 2D contour. And lastly, we're going to jump right down and we're going to talk about manual contact only. So here opens up a new selection for me to go out to the screen, select points on my flats. I grab them. I come in, end my selection, let my auto regen take over here, and it puts paths only at the depths I selected. So they've really taken Waterline and kind of turned into our ultimate 2D finishing tool working with 3D models.